Human DNA consists of 23 pairs of chromosomes with 3 billion nitrogenous base pairs. And surely, I mean, we don't need all of that to function, right? How hard can it be? Hey there, peoples. Julian here for DNews. I'm sure what I'm about to say is review for many of you, but just to make sure everyone's on the same page, I'll reiterate. You need DNA. Red blood cells being the exception, all the cells in your body have it. For most of those cells, you have 23 pairs of long DNA sequences called chromosomes. The DNA is structured like a spirally ladder, and the rungs of these ladders are the nitrogenous base pairs adenine and thymine, and guanine and cytosine. You repeat and rearrange those four bases enough, and bingo, you got yourself a blueprint to build a human being. Or a potato. How you arrange them is key. Okay, everybody up to speed? Great. So, just how many of these base pairs do you need? For a human, not a potato. When we examine our 23 chromosomes, it would seem the answer is a little more than 3 billion. 3 billion ATGCs to make a Steve. A potato only has 840 million base pairs by comparison, and that makes sense, right? Steve's a pretty complex guy, certainly more so than a potato. Though, interestingly, the potato has 24 pairs of chromosomes to our 23. They're just all a lot shorter. But don't be misled into thinking that more DNA equals more awesomeness. An organism with a genome 50 times bigger than ours isn't going to necessarily be a telepath or have laser vision or the power to control magnetic fields or an increased healing factor or anything like that. It could be something as simple as a flower. Actually, it is. At over 150 billion base pairs in length, the flower Paris japonica is the largest genome ever accurately measured. The amoeboid Polychaos dubium was estimated to be even bigger at 670 billion base pairs, but its claim to the throne is disputed because the techniques used to measure genome sizes in the 60s have since proven flawed. It's not the size of the DNA that matters, though, it's how you use it. At the other end of the spectrum, there are bacteria with genomes that don't even break a million base pairs. Nessuia deltacephalin E. coli has the smallest genome ever discovered, measuring it at just 112,000 base pairs, though it needs to live in symbiosis with another bacterium to survive. Nanocarium equitans gets by with a scant 490,000 base pairs encoding 540 genes. It's the smallest independent cellular unit ever discovered. Scientists recently synthesized a minimalist genome of just 530,000 base pairs that encodes just 473 genes by whittling away 70,000 base pairs of the already diminutive Mycoplasma genitalium. That's right. Organisms can live without all their DNA. In fact, it's estimated that you're only using about 8% of your genome. 1% of it is coding proteins, 7% is regulating when to use that first 1%, and the remaining 92% is just junk as far as we can tell. That number is disputed, and by a different measurement and with the loosest definitions, as much as 80% of our DNA may serve some function, but that still means 60 million base pairs are just along for the ride. Evolution provides a good explanation for why we're carrying around all this extra baggage. Becoming human was a long and messy path, and along the way, some DNA is going to mutate into disuse, but keeping it around won't be too much of a hassle. In fact, having all those extra ATGCs to work with means mutations are less likely to occur on an essential gene, and therefore won't be catastrophic. It may actually be beneficial, giving random chance the opportunity to mutate junk DNA into something useful and giving an organism the edge. As a bonus, the process of evolution explains why a flower can have 50 times more DNA than we do. Just how much of your DNA is junk is still up for debate. It may actually be used to make important things, like your face. Anthony Carboni explains here.
Turns out that most of this seemingly useless DNA has a very large effect on us. The DNA that seems to be giving us all our dashing good looks are called enhancers. They don't do anything on their own, but they control how much other genes express themselves.
Are you surprised about your genome being bloated, or is it no big deal to you? Let us know in the comments, subscribe for more, and I will see you next time on DNews.